Clanny McClanfaces. How's everybody doing? Next step in the backyard portable container break room workshop thing build is to seal whatever gaps I have. For example, here, you can see that because this was hit and bent, so this separated ever so slightly. I want to go on the outside of the building and fill any gaps like that. I want to do it on the outside because the idea is to not allow any rain or anything into the building, because there will be insulation here, and if the water gets through, you can see here for example, it'll wet the insulation if I do the caulking on the inside. So I would like to do it on the outside. Makes sense? So I went to Home Depot, hashtag no affiliation, and I bought a box, a 12 pack of this contractor, so it must be serious, Alex Painters. I don't know who that is. It's an acrylic latex caulk, good for indoor and outdoor use. I got this stuff, it's white. I was gonna get clear, but I knew I needed quite a bit. I don't know if I need 12, but I didn't want to grab one or two and realize I needed more. I can always use this stuff around the house. It's quick drying, 2 hour paint ready. Not gonna paint, water cleanup, 25 years. They had a 40 year one. I'll be dead 25 years or so, I'm guessing, so it doesn't really matter. And this stuff, so the 25 year and in white, I got a dozen of these for 25 bucks, which was a really good price. The other ones were the 40 year one. It was called like, I don't know, Alex Painter Plus or something like that. That was 33 and change. And they had some other stuff that was like 45 and up. So 25 bucks, it's gonna do what I needed to do, right? So I'm gonna get ready to do that. But the first thing I'd like to try tackling from the outside again, I'm filming inside right now and talking to you because as you can see, it's quite windy outside. You will not hear me talking. So I'm filling you in here and then you can watch me work outside. I want to try and straighten that out a little bit more. What I did do off camera is there were three self-tapping screws like these out here. I took them out. So this way I'm hoping I can push that in closer and flatter to this bottom lip from the outside and then screw it in. I'll grab some more of these self-tappers that are just randomly laying around. And as long as I can get that pretty close and screw it in so I can run a bead of caulk, that I'll do on the inside, then I think I'll be okay. Otherwise, I'll have to come up with something else. So that's what I'm gonna do now. I'll go outside, I'll turn the camera on so you can watch because you're all voyeurs, and try and straighten that out as best I can, and then move on to caulking anywhere I see issues. I think I'm also going to caulk like on the outside of this. Gosh, that's so ugly. I'm gonna caulk on the outside of it and just try and smooth it down a little, because you can paint over that stuff, so just kind of seal that up a little more. Not sure. My neighbor who did the electrical is looking for a snap-in plastic cover for that from the outside. If not, I'll take a square cover and silicone it on the outside and let it just bond. But you'll see, all right? Okay, folks, let's get started.
We have this one day in mind. Let me show you real quick. What I'm trying to do right now is, sorry about the wind. Under here, see how this is bent, right? So I'm trying to straighten that out. I'm having success. So if I can straighten that out, this does not necessarily have to pull all the way down, but as long as I can get it down just enough to screw some of that into there, or at least next to it, then I can get it sealed enough that I can caulk it from the inside. Okay. Carry on.
Pushing that in, which is flattening the bottom somewhat. So now, sorry, I'm blocking your way. So now, I might be able to screw this down in a couple of spots. Have it close enough that I can seal it from the inside. Let's see. I don't know if these will pierce or if I need to drill. Pre-drill. I'm quite happy. Okay. I found one of these larger ones that have these rubber washers on them, and I found a handful of smaller ones, so I think I'll put the large one in the corner and then just kind of fill in between the gaps. Can you see? I found another one of these big ones with the washers. I think that's good. So much better. I mean, it's ugly. I can hit that from the inside now, though. Let's go take a look. Check that out. So much better. Right? I mean, there's a gap there, right? And a little bit there, but I can caulk all that and it'll be okay. I do want to knock this out just a smidge. Because I think it'll be better. I don't know if you caught all that. I'm sure you heard it. Nice. I'm happy with that. I like it. It's much better than I imagined. Good. Okay. I just want to try and screw that in. Let's see if my impact driver fits. Barely. I'm trying to do it one-handed. That's the tricky part. That should pull. Hang on. Gamoto. Cursed. I cursed in Greek. There we go. Nice. Nice. That one's in. Cool. Little gap right there. I don't think I'll be able to. Look at that. Oh, this is my other favorite hammer. I think it's like a rock hammer. As opposed to a disco hammer. You know what? I may go around and do that everywhere there's a gap and see if it helps before we move on to caulking. This is kind of working. You see that gap right there? I'm trying to avoid the wires, but it closed it somewhat. So much better. I can't pop that out I've tried, don't want to mess up my window. Friends, I really think that's it. Wow, success. I feel success. All right, let's go outside. I'm just gonna set you up on the 3-foot pod and start caulking. All right. It's very windy, so my mouth is right up against the microphone. I apologize if you can't hear me very well. I'm done with the exterior. I covered over all the welded spots. That's just ugly as heck, but it's okay. I don't care. Filled in all the seams. I'm going to come back in with a wet rag and clean up all the excess. Right, same thing here, filled in all these little holes. I had to overdo it a bit, but it's really okay. I don't mind. I'll be painting it. I'm not making a showroom, you know, it's a workshop. Went around, there. I also noticed some of the windows, I guess when they installed them, they kind of cracked vinyl siding, like up there. I know that they siliconed around it. Sorry about the wind. I just put some extra to make sure. Here's that inside spot that I was hammering. Came out all right, actually. So now let's go inside and we can finish up in this area. Excuse me, right? I'll just fill that in, get rid of some of that dirt. You can see here where some of the silicone peeked through. Man, I'm so happy with that. It's ugly, but like I said. And then here's the funny part. All the stuff I did on the outside, I haven't finished even one tube. It's almost finished. So I have 11 tubes, here it is. I have 11 tubes left. So I'm definitely gonna fill in these gaps. I'll go around and see if there's anywhere else, like right here, I can see some sunlight, you know? And maybe, because I have enough of this stuff, maybe I'll just go around and fill everything. It won't hurt. Let's see. Let me go get the tripod. That's the pod with three legs. And that was silly, huh? Because pod means foot. So, you know, in Greek, foot, 3 feet. So, anyway, yeah, let me go get the tripod, set you up for that, and then I'll decide what I want to do. All right, let's see what I got left. I'm not even going to wipe it, because I don't care. What's a little dirt amongst friends? You know what I'm saying? The nice part about this is I don't have to wipe this. Okay, that's the end of it. That's it. Let's open a fresh one. I shaked you. Sorry. America. Oh, I squashed it. Let's see if it'll go in. I don't know if it will. There we go! Huzzah! There's tar on it from a previous puncture. Let's go. There we are. Can you hear all the kids driving around in their four-wheeler things? I am so happy with this. A little more. Right there. Can you see me here? I'm gonna do this one too. If you have any caulking tips, let me know. My caulking lines are good. Until I wipe them, then they suck. Good, suck. Good, suck. That's full of dirt. In the corners, my head in your way. Sorry. I think I'm just going to go around and do the whole bottom because I can. I have plenty and I do see daylight. It won't hurt anything. You know what I'm saying? Okay, I'm going to do that. You don't need to watch the whole thing, do you? I just wanna. Do you wanna? I'll just film and fast forward. There we go. Damn, that looks good. Look at it. Looks good. So I'm not gonna wipe it. I mean, I don't have to. But look, schnazzy. Okay, folks, I'm just gonna continue fourth or fifth. All right, well, I'm done with the caulk. I went all around the bottom of every wall, across. I got behind everything. Into the other room. I had to sweep out a little, some of the gunk, you know. But yeah, just kind of sealed all the way around. And I have to say, it's like 10 degrees warmer now and less oxygen because it's hermetically sealed. The way I know that is I called my Greek god Hermes and he agreed. And if he doesn't know, who does? So yeah, siliconing is done. Straightening of the walls is done. welding is done. That was the last video. So let's move on. Real quick, I was going to silicone a square plate over this, and then I'm gonna wait. I think I mentioned my buddy might have a cap I can put in there, and if not, I'll silicone something on that. But I'm not sure what I'm doing here yet. I don't know if it's gonna be a window or a vent fan or louvers with a vent fan. So I don't wanna stick something there to only have to then tear it back off. So for the time being, that's fine like that. I'm even tempted to, I have some magnetic self-adhesive strips, just adhere it to a piece of metal and just put a magnet on top of there just for the time being. So here's this stuff. It's about 4 hours before you can paint it. I'm gonna go around, not today, and just kind of scrape off all the excess. But yeah, I'm happy with the progress for today. Hey everybody, so it's like a month since I filmed what you just watched. The weather just has not been conducive to working on the workshop. We've had very, very high winds and a lot of rain, and I need to bring insulation from outside in, as well as carrying the interior walls, which are very tall and floppy. And that's just not gonna happen in that kind of weather. So, rather than ending the video abruptly, I just wanted to let you know what's going on and why it's taken so long to upload this video. Furthermore, I'm leaving in a couple days. I'll be on vacation for a while. So I wanted to have something to share with you while I'm gone. And as soon as I get back, the weather should be just fine for carrying on with insulating, and then painting, and then installing the AC system, and then we're ready to go. So I'm pretty excited, and I'm more so excited that I'm getting to go away for a while. So be well, enjoy whatever it is you enjoy, and talk to you as soon as I come back. Take care, bye for now, and talk to you soon.